Hello everyone, welcome to MSFT webcast. In this video guide, we will have a look at the steps on how to install and configure data deduplication in Windows Server 2019. Data deduplication is a rule service in Windows Server 2019 that conserves storage space on an NTFS or REFS volume. When enabled, data deduplication optimizes free space on a volume by examining the data on the volume by looking for duplicated portions. Duplicated portions of the volume's dataset are stored once and are optionally compressed for additional savings. For this demo, I'm using the TSLAB created in VirtualBox. This is our member server with the name WS2K19-SRV02. On this server, we are going to install and configure data deduplication feature. First, let's install data deduplication feature on this server. And for that, I'm going to click on Manage and select Add Rules and Features. On Before You Begin screen, we need to click on Next button, select Rule-based or Feature-based installation, and click on Next. Our member server is already selected, WS2K19-SRV02. Let's click on Next. On Select Server Rules, we need to expand File and Storage Services. Then we need to expand File and iSCSI Services. And after that, we need to select Data Deduplication feature. Let's select the checkbox. Click on Next. Next again, and click on Install. After installing Data Deduplication feature, our next step is to enable it by using a SOAR Manager console. First, I'm going to click on Close to close this console. And then after, on SOAR Manager console, I'm going to click on File and Storage Services. Then we need to click on Volumes. Select the volume on which you want to enable data deduplication. For this video, I'm going to enable data deduplication on a volume with the drive letter D. Let's select the volume, right-click on it, and select Configure Data Deduplication. It will start a new wizard for us. By default, data deduplication is disabled for all volumes. By clicking on this drop-down menu, we can select the desired user type. There are three different user types available on Windows Server 2019. The first one is General Purpose File Server. The second one for Virtual Desktop Infrastructure Server, which we can use with Hyper-V. And the third one is Virtualized Backup Server, which is specially designed for virtualized backup applications such as Microsoft Data Protection Manager. For the purpose of this demo, we are going to select General Purpose File Server. Once you select that user's type, you will have some other options as well. The first one is deduplicate files older than in days. Here, I'm going to specify 0. Then, here we have some other options to exclude certain extensions for deduplication settings. Then, if you want to exclude any particular folder, that time you need to click on this Add button and then select the folder which you want to exclude from this process. I'm going to click on Cancel button because we want to include entire volume. If you would like to change the data deduplication schedule, you can do so by clicking on Set Deduplication Schedule. Once you click on it, it will give us one more console on which we can select the schedule. By default, Enable Background Optimization options is selected. Here, you can select this checkbox for Enable Throughput Optimization, as well as you can create a second schedule for Throughput Optimization as well. Keep in mind that those two schedules will use a CPU and consume resources, so it's preferable to set those outside of business hours and outside of backup window too. You have to wait for the scheduled task to run for the deduplication engine to start working. For the purpose of this video, we are not going to select it. So let me click on Cancel button, click on Apply, and click on OK. As you can see, deduplication rate is currently 0%. And deduplication savings is 0.0 byte. Because data deduplication is not yet performed on a volume D. To manually test data deduplication, I'm going to open Windows PowerShell. Let's right-click on Start button and select Windows PowerShell Admin. At PowerShell, I'm going to type simdelete start-dtupjob. Then we need to specify our volume by using switch-volume. It will be a D in our case. And then we need to specify switch-type and type will be optimization. Let's press Enter key. As you can see, schedule type is manual and progress is at 0%. Okay, let's minimize Windows PowerShell. Let's go to Server Manager and let's click on Refresh button. And here we can see, now we can see some data on our Server Manager console. Under deduplication rate, you can verify that 38% is there. And under deduplication savings, as you can see, it has saved 298 MB of space on your volume D. Let's right click on our volume D and select properties. On the property console of volume D, we can verify that deduplication is enabled and deduplication savings is 298 MB of data and deduplication rate is 38%. After seeing this result, we can say we have successfully enabled data deduplication on volume D. That's it for this video demonstration on how to install and configure data deduplication on Windows Server 2019.